What's up guys, today I'm gonna give you some reasons why I chose the 2018 Mustang over a Camaro, and I was also looking at a Miata, so stay tuned. I wanna hop trains, wanna win the lotto, and buy my mama a sick condo, in my Chuck Taylors and my Tempo, and I want it all. I wanna work less, but I wanna make more. In the Jerry Lambo, if you wanna hang tight or you... So I should mention that this car has some small mods already done to the car. For example, it has a Roush axle back, and I did some little mods to the pedals, and anyways, that'll be another video for you guys to watch. Okay, so the first thing you'll notice, I don't have the 301A package, which has the touchscreen and all that. I've heard some bad things about the touchscreen head unit anyways, and at the same time, I don't think it's really worth the $2,000 or something it was for just the 301A package. And honestly, for me, personal preference, I like having buttons and things that are just quick. Reliable, and I don't have to mess with looking at a touchscreen, touching them and all that stuff while driving. Buttons for me are just easy to use, quick, and as long as I have Bluetooth, I'm happy with it. What else should I say? So this Mustang is a base package Mustang. There's nothing thrown into it, no performance package, and I'll explain why I did all of this. I didn't want anything. And specifically down the road, I do have plans on a lot of mods anyways. This one does not have the entire one screen digital cluster display. And personally, I do love just having analog, the two classic gauge pod style cluster that's always been in the Mustangs. And this little screen in the middle actually has a lot of functions already in it. You have all these extra information. Okay, so the number one reason why I got the base model is simply because I got this car for $30,000, and it was a good deal to the point where I could not even pass up. And in my mind, personally, I did not want, like, with the performance package and the 301A package, it comes to like 40 something thousand or 40,000. And to me, I could never see myself buying a Ford or paying $40,000 for a, you know, a Ford. And to me, it's just not worth it really. If I was gonna spend anywhere above 40 or 40-ish, then I'm looking into something else, you know, not a Mustang, of course. So with that being said, I was looking at a Miata and also the Camaro SS, and I come from a bunch of only import cars. I never purchased any American car ever in my life, so this is my first ever American product. I was a little bit hesitant because of, I just know how Fords run and not always the best. So anyways, I didn't buy the Miata because I decided I wanted to try American muscle, and just, you know, I know how Miatas drive like, and maybe this time I should try something else. My girlfriend was like, maybe you should look at a Mustang, you know, because we went to a car show one time, and my girlfriend and I, she was like, oh, you look good in that Mustang. And I was like, really? For the Camaro, for me, it was just, I really didn't like the looks of it compared to the new 2018 Mustangs. One funny thing was that when I saw the 2018 Mustang facelift, you know, on all over the internet before it ever was actually out, I thought it was ugly and horrible, and the older ones looked better. But of course, when I see it in person, it was totally a different story. And honestly, if you have not seen it in person, I would definitely say keep your thoughts until you actually see the car in person, because it actually does look much better in person. I know the Camaro is a better like handling car, track car or something, and out of the box I know it just blows the performance of the Mustang, but for me, I really love the way this Mustang drives. So far, driving this car is amazingly smooth and quiet, just for a sports car. I should say, not a muscle car, I don't know, whatever, sports car. The interior is, in my opinion, much more pleasing to the eye, I guess. And the Camaro just, I don't know, it's really quirky looking. The Camaro has a screen that's like here and then it tilts this way, or I think it's like somewhere more like here. But at the same time, it has these two huge circular air vents and it just doesn't look right. I don't know, like air, it should be up here, not all the way down here. I don't know. And I just don't like the way the Camaro's steering wheel looks, and just overall, the design wise for the Camaro, I just don't like it. Especially the rear end. The rear end of Camaros have always looked very boring to me, and they always just look the same to, and it's just like, it has that typical square box look. The front end, I think, looks good when the 2017 models came out for the SS models. Those actually look good on the front end, but other than the front end, to me, I think everything else kind of looks kind of plain. Yeah, so overall, I got this Mustang and I've been loving it, and I have right now 1800 miles. I've had this for about a month now. So at the end of the day, I just wanted a V8 Mustang with a stick shift, and that's it, nothing else. And even though the base model comes with very ridiculous skinny 235 tires all around, it doesn't really matter, because if you buy a base, you should have plans to change a lot of the parts anyways, if that's your plan, unless you just like the base, I guess. I have a set of wheels and tires already planned. There's already several things I've done to this car, and I'll show you guys real quick in a minute. Or I think I'm just gonna post up separate videos of what I shot when I installed those parts, so look out for that. Alright, hope you guys enjoyed this video, and hopefully you got something out of it if you're in the market for any of these cars, because you know, at the end of the day, they're all nice cars, the Mustang, the Challenger, and the Camaro. It just depends, it just comes down to what you want and your preference. So yeah, and within the 1800 miles that I've driven, I've had no issues, and hopefully, you know, knock on wood, nothing does happen. The 6-speed has been no problems at all either. I've seen some people having like issues with them, but luckily I have no problems yet. Anyways, peace out, guys.